In 1948, Dr. Orvar Swenson, a pioneer pediatric surgeon at Boston Children's Hospital, designed and introduced an operation to take care of patients born with Hirschsprung disease. We are all in debt with him because of that operation, many thousands of children have saved without those procedures. Later on, other surgeons all over the world introduced technical modifications to the original Orvar Swenson technique, but all of them based on the principle rationale of the original operation. And the last one that was introduced that we use at present time because of the technical advantages and better results is the so-called transanal operation introduced by Dr. Luis de la Torre, who now works in our center. These procedures save many lives, but unfortunately, about 30% of all patients with Hirschsprung disease still suffer from a condition called enterocolitis. This is a kind of mysterious, serious condition that still kills children at present time. These babies suffer from abdominal distension, manifestations of sepsis, bacterial translocation, and growth and proliferation of unusual bad bacteria. We don't know exactly the origin of this condition, but we do know what are the predisposing factors, including the stasis of stool, in other words, incapacity to pass through, retention of stool. And also we know that the use of broad-spectrum antibiotics contributes to the proliferation of bad bacteria. The treatment for this condition, the most effective treatment, is the use of rectal colonic irrigations and the administration of flagyl, a medication that kills most of the abnormal bacteria that grows in the colon. The rectal irrigation is a life-saving maneuver. And what we have done in our institution is to create the routine of prophylactic irrigations. We teach the mothers how to do irrigations even before the operation for Hirschsprung disease. We also try to increase the index of suspicion of the mothers to detect early manifestation of enterocolitis and start irrigations as soon as possible. By doing that, they save the baby's life. We want to avoid the very sad situation in which babies who had a successful operation for Hirschsprung are discharged from the hospital and without telling the mothers what the risk of enterocolitis is. The babies get very sick. They go in the middle of the night to a general hospital, and in most institutions, doctors don't know much about enterocolitis, and sometimes babies die. So the mothers of our patients become experts and suspect the condition, and they do it at home at the first early manifestations of this condition, and by doing that, we save many lives. Fortunately, enterocolitis is not seen in adolescents. As time goes by, the incidence of enterocolitis decreases, and therefore the babies have the opportunity to live a normal life.